Welcome, brothers and sisters. Welcome to the final video of Triple Grace for today. If you're wondering why you only see two videos today, we have made a live stream this morning. Go to the section of life and watch the replay. It's about a teaching about the bride, the bridesmaids, and the bridegroom. Who is who? Share that live stream with everybody. It's very important. Now in this final video for today of Triple Grace, I will talk about grace. Walk as instructed. 1 Thessalonians 4:8. To each one of us, grace has been given. You have received a great amount of revelation through Triple Grace in this channel here. The question is, are you walking as instructed? Now you can see, where is it written that we have to walk as instructed? I take you to that scripture right now. 1 Thessalonians 4:8. Therefore, anyone who rejects this instruction does not reject a human being, but God, the very God who gives you his Holy Spirit. Brothers and sisters, this is a stern warning. Do not reject the revelation that you are receiving by grace. To each one of us, grace has been given, but are you walking as instructed? Are you following the commandments of the Lord? Have you separated yourself from the world, Babylon, and the churches? Are you walking the kingdom path? Have you supported kingdom purposes? Are you building an ark? Have you understood all this? Are you truly walking as instructed? Or are you still a mocker and scoffer, following your own ways? Then you are rejecting the one that has given you the message, and that is God himself. Grace is given to you. The question is how you are handling this grace. Do you write the grace on your soul, your heart, your mind? And are you following God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit? Or are you still moving from one excuse to another one, clinging to the old ways, clinging to your pastors that is clearly a wolf in sheep's clothing, that is not teaching you about revelation, nor about prophecy, but just tingling your ears so that you can give instead for kingdom purposes, so that you can give into the world? Satan has done a great work by reducing grace to a small level only. Only a few churches are worthy to be called that. Therefore, you need to separate yourself and to enter the new church, Acts 2.0, the true church, the true bride that will be taken into the Father's house to the wedding. Watch that live stream for today. Get an understanding. Brothers and sisters, great grace is given to you in many numbers, in 555, in 222, in 77, or 777. The Lord is operating in full prophetic gifts. Not only through Triple Grace, but through many other prophetic voices also. And they're all aligning up and they're all coming into unity, telling you the same thing. Jesus is standing in the cloud now to take out the children, take them out of harm's way, and then justice will be served. War is coming. But he has also promised that he will protect his bride, that he will protect his harvest as long as it is for kingdom, for the kingdom, for kingdom purposes. Great understanding was given to you. What are you doing with it? Are you sharing it to your friends and family so that they can find the path that will lead them to Mount Zion, where they will be raptured into paradise? Or are you still staying with the diluted crowd that believe that the whole church will be raptured now? Do you really believe that the whole church has made themselves ready to be a bride without spot and wrinkles? Satan wants that you are not moving. He wants that you remain seated. He wants that you are not standing up. He wants that you remain in the world. Babylon, that's Jezebel, and the churches, his fake teachers that he's sending out, so that you are ensnared, that you are remain in bondage and slavery to his world, to his kingdom. But when you separate yourself, you walk through that open door that God and Jesus has given you, and you will then be freed from that bondage and slavery. And you will see now that a great kingdom is opening up to you, where you will be a prince and princess, a co-heir to the throne. Great grace is given to you. Use it correctly, spread it, bring in the harvest. Stop immediately supporting worldly issues and use all what you have, everything, as God has commanded you. Jesus said, sell everything you have, give it for kingdom purposes, or give it to the poor, and then take your cross and follow me. Use all your resources that you have for kingdom purposes only. Build an ark so that you have a place where God can cover you. Stand with us in unity together. Be part of Operation Kingdom. That is also grace that God is giving you, to stand fully armored. He is covering you. He is protecting you on the battle lines. These are the holy places that will come forth to show forth great light, to bring in the harvest and to charge the enemy, to take the battle to the gates. Are you part of it? What is holding you back? Only the world, only Jezebel, Babylon, and only your pastors, your churches, your old ways. But God has said, I'm making a new thing, and the new thing is grace and his unconditional love that he has for all of you. He is calling you back into the kingdom right now. You need to decide, brothers and sisters, because to each one of you, grace has been given. And you need to walk as instructed. 1 Thessalonians 4, verse 8. Walk as instructed. Make yourself ready to be part of the wedding as a true bride of Christ. The cup of betrothal will be given to you now. Will you accept it? Will you drink it and accept the betrothal of the Son? He is calling you into marriage now. But that requires that you prepare yourself, that you clothe yourself in fine white linen, that you select the bridesmaids, that you invite the wedding guests. The day will come. Also, we do not know the day nor the hour. Only the Father knows. The day will come at the sixth seal when Jesus will come for his bride. If you are then not ready, you will stand naked as the Church of Laodicea in the trumpet tribulation period, because you were not watching. When the thief in the night, Jesus Christ, the bridegroom, came, you missed the midnight cry, you missed your visitation. Don't miss your betrothal now. This is a time of betrothal when he comes for the children. This is a time that you watch this guy. And the cup will be given to you. The cup of betrothal. Drink from it. Become the true bride of Christ. Grace, grace, grace is extended to you. To each one of you, grace has been given. Walk as instructed and be blessed by the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Maranatha.